Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.6 to all iOS 13 supported devices. That means if your device supported iOS 13, it will support this version. This came in at a very large 3.75 gigabytes if you're going from the beta to the public version. Now, if you are on iOS 13.6 GM, you already have the final version. It's the exact same thing. If you don't have the GM and maybe you're updating from iOS 13.5.1, expect the update to be much smaller. So this particular update has a lot of interesting things in it, but if you're going from the GM version to the public, all you need to do is remove the beta profile if you've got it installed. So go to your settings, go to general, go to profile, delete the profile, and that will remove the profile from your device, and you'll no longer get any more iOS 13 betas if they decide to put out another one after 13.6. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about everything new. The build number is 17G68, and I'm running it on my iPhone 11. I also have it on the iPhone 6S Plus, as well as the iPad Air 2. And this particular update, if you're coming from a beta, does not have a modem update, so cellular connectivity won't be affected at all. But if you're coming from 13.5.1, you may see that update. Now, as far as new features in this, while there are a few, of course, this isn't iOS 14, so it doesn't have major changes, but it does have a few things. And the first thing has to do with settings. So if we go into settings, and then you go to general, and then you go to software update, you'll see under software update that you have customize automatic updates. If you go into customize automatic updates, you can set it to download iOS updates automatically and also install iOS updates automatically. This is a new option that allows you to decide whether or not you even want it to download an update onto your phone. So maybe you don't want the next update right away. You want to save storage on your phone. Turn it off and you'll be good to go. Now, when it comes to Wi-Fi, there's actually a feature we can't see that is for administrators. So depending on how you're connecting, probably at this point in time, you may be working remotely and connected through a VPN. Administrators can now specify domains to be excluded from always connected VPN connections. So this is an administrative option that they've added and is available only through those devices that are being administered from a company. So that's there for administrators, and you can't really see that, at least in the settings. Now in health, we have a couple new options. So if we go into health, you'll see you'll have your normal summary of your activity and movement and things like that. But if we go to browse down in the bottom, and then scroll down a little, we now have symptoms. And symptoms is a new category where we can put in information based on if we have anything from acne to chills to congestion to fainting, fatigue, any of these things, loss of smell, hot flashes, any of these things can be updated. And this could be an easy way to record this information should you need to do that for a doctor or you want to keep track of it yourself. You also will have the option to share this with third-party applications if you want to. Of course, you don't need to use it at all, but say you had a sore throat. Now in this part of the application, you can add data and select whether or not you're having any symptoms, whether they're mild, moderate, severe, and when you're actually presenting with those symptoms. So if you'd like to use this, it's now a feature within the health app. Now, one new feature is digital car keys. Now, this is a feature you can't necessarily see and you would add through Apple Wallet. So if you're in Wallet, for example, you go into Wallet, it loads, you hit the little plus, and you can add a digital car key. This allows you to unlock and lock your car using your phone by tapping it to an NFC area or bringing it close to an area. And specifically, the only cars that support it right now are brand new BMWs that just started production. So they may or may not be available by the time you're watching this, but you can use that paired with your phone to actually unlock your car, start your car, and in the future, you'll just leave it in your pocket or a purse, get next to the car, unlock it, and get in and go. Now, there's also a new feature because of car keys that allows you to have what's called power reserve. So maybe your battery is depleted down to zero, your phone shuts off, you'll still have up to 5 hours of battery life to unlock your car, according to Apple. So it's a power reserve feature specifically for that that should help if you have no battery power left in your phone. Now with Apple News, Apple has updated quite a lot in here for those that may be visually impaired or just want to listen to the news on the go. So if you go into the News app, and I really don't use News, but maybe I'll start using it more, we'll wait for it to load. And of course you can scroll through your news stories, but down at the bottom, we have a new audio button. If we tap on audio, you'll see that we have a daily news brief that we can listen to. This is updated daily and it's free for everyone. However, if you subscribe to Apple News Plus, you can listen to a lot of news from those that actually add it. Apple will update this regularly where you can listen to your news. So that could be really helpful for those that just want to listen to their news on the way to work or continue to listen to news because you're visually impaired. Either way, you'll have the ability to listen to news now. Now, also, if you're getting daily newsletters, those can be personalized in mail. So if you go into your following, scroll down here, just keep going. You'll see notification and email. Go into that. And then we can unfollow news that we don't want to listen to. We just want to turn these off, not listen to different news channels. You can listen to some, not listen to others. Maybe you don't want to receive any. Just turn them all off, leave them on, whatever works for you, set it up, and then you'll get your daily news brief that way. So that's a really nice option since I get these every day and I never remembered even signing up for them. So it's nice that I have the option now. And then finally in news, they've updated it so that if you live in New York City, LA, Houston, or San Francisco, there's now more comprehensive coverage. So if you live in those metro areas, you'll have the ability to have additional news every day. Now that's it for the actual new features in iOS 13.6, but there's a lot of bug fixes as well. And so the first one has to do with using iCloud Drive. So if you're using iCloud Drive and it's syncing, prior to this, apps could become unresponsive. So maybe you open the weather app and it just wouldn't work while things were syncing. Everything should work properly now. It also fixes an issue where some calls from Saskatchewan appeared as though they were originating from the United States. So that should be resolved if you were having that problem. There's also fixes to more calls when it comes to Wi-Fi calling, and Apple has updated Wi-Fi calling so that audio now works properly. Prior to this, I even had this issue. I'd place a phone call on Wi-Fi calling and the audio would drop. That should now be resolved. And then also, if you're using an iPhone 6S or a first generation iPhone SE and were not able to register your phone to use Wi-Fi calling, that should now work properly. So if you're trying to use Wi-Fi calling, that should work now. Now, if you're using an eSIM instead of a physical SIM card like we would have in this iPhone 11, what you might have had before is if you were roaming, it could still show as disabled. Now it will show properly if it's enabled. So it's just a little bug they had there. Now with the iPad, if you're using a physical keyboard with an iPad, maybe you have it paired with an iPad or maybe even a phone, what could happen is maybe you go to a website and it prompts you for a keyboard and you go to change the actual website URL you want to go to, it would still pop up this keyboard from time to time, even if you had a physical keyboard. They've now resolved that so it won't pop up anymore. So that was a little bit annoying for some people, so I'm glad that they've fixed that. And then also with keyboards, they fixed an issue where Japanese keyboards would incorrectly be mapped to United States keyboards. So that should all be fixed. And finally, if you're using assistive touch, Control Center may have been unresponsive. So Control Center should now work properly if you're using assistive touch. So that's great to see that they fixed that. Now, other than the features and the bug fixes I've mentioned, Apple also linked to security updates as well. Now, these are not always updated right away, but Apple can usually be expected to have at least a few security updates with each concurrent major public release. So expect the device to get a little bit more secure. Maybe they found a few loopholes or things like that for security. Expect that to be patched. Now, don't expect any more new features until iOS 14 is released. We may see an iOS 13.7. It's really hard to say at this point, but I think Apple will release iOS 13.7 betas, maybe, or maybe we'll just see an iOS 13.6.1 to fix minor things until iOS 14 comes out a little bit later this year. So don't expect anything major until then. Now, as far as battery life on this particular device, well, battery life is a little bit hard for me to measure with this because this is not my main iOS version. I've been running iOS 14 Beta 2 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max for a little while, and it's something I really enjoy using, and it's hard to use two phones at once and just determine what battery life is like. but most people are saying 13.6 is much better than iOS 13.5.1. So on my iPhone 11, my battery health is quite good. And in fact, I've considered moving to this device for a little while because it doesn't have PWM or flickering the display like OLED displays. But if we go to battery health, you'll see this one's at 100%. And I haven't used it very much recently since updating or anything else. So my battery life isn't very up to date, of course, on this device, but many of you have said that it's very good. And in fact, here's a screenshot from one I looked at recently with the GM that makes it look like it's pretty good. I think this will last throughout the day. You should get 10 to 12 hours on something like an 11 Pro Max. Performance has been quite good as well on older devices. I showed Minecraft in the iOS 13.6 GM video, but in general, the performance is quite good. Frame rates are great. You'll wait for this to load. This is just Wi-Fi loading here. You'll see once it's loaded, scrolling is nice. And this is on an iPhone 6S Plus, one of the oldest supported devices. Scrolling is nice and fast. Everything just seems to keep up well. So don't expect it to get any slower. It seems like it's going to be this fast all the time. Now, as far as iPad OS, the same thing can be said. This is one of the oldest supported iPads. So this is an iPad Air 2. Again, scrolling is fairly fast. Sometimes it will stutter from time to time after it reloads. You can see there's a little bit of a frame rate stutter from time to time. It's not a huge deal on a device this old, although I wish they would keep it a little bit faster. Again, back and forth, multitasking, we can go back into Safari, and things seem to load fairly reasonably. So they're not too bad here, and I think it's very usable at this point and shouldn't have an issue. But don't expect any other features other than what I've already mentioned with iOS 13.6 on iPadOS 13.6. That's it for iOS 13.6. Now, let me know if you're using iOS 13.6, or maybe you decided to try out iOS 14 betas. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.